you've got some very important geological features that cut across the New Zealand landscape. The Alpine Fault is one of the most significant active faults, and here it is at this place called Calf Paddock alongside the Maruia River. We've got a team of geologists who are working here in an excavation that's across and through the fault scarp of the Alpine Fault. This team of geologists is busy looking at the layers which were deposited across the fault by the river and by other processes. So we've got two of these excavated trenches at the site. We're only here for a few days, and after that these trenches will be filled in. So let's go and look at the kind of evidence that we're looking for past earthquakes. So as we look from one side of the fault here, we can see these layered gravels and things, but as we cross across the area where we've got the fault mapped out, the layers change completely in their character and form as we go down the fault scarp. So imagine now if a very large earthquake happened right away as we're standing here, then this fault would move and the deposits would be faulted again. So this side of the fault over here would actually go up, and this side of the fault would go down. At the end of the shaking, what you would probably see is that there was a break in the earth here and the fault scarp would grow, and the deposits from this side of the fault would tend to tip across onto the other side of the fault and form what we call a colluvium or a colluvial wedge. Colluvial wedges are wedge-shaped deposits of deformed material. Here's one made of gravel. Here's another one here, which form after individual earthquake movements. What we try to do is to find organic material, carbonaceous material, old buried grass or grass seeds or wood or charcoal that was at the surface at the time of that earthquake, that we can date the stuff with using a technique called radiocarbon dating. If we know the age of the colluvial deposit, then we can get the timing of that past earthquake. So once we get some dates on these earthquakes and we understand the history of earthquakes at this site, we compare the record here with sites at other places along the Alpine Fault so that we can see how long individual earthquake fault movements might have been. Those help us to understand the overall history of the fault along the length of it through the South Island.